Alright, let's press over to the...
The time has almost come for our drivers to
the
fight
future race.
Wheel to wheel. Race day has arrived.
Motor car racing didn't have the best of starts at Spa-Francorchamps. Only one driver registered for the very first car race back in 1921, so a motorbike race replaced it instead. Times have changed, and now Spa is a solid fixture on the F1 calendar.
There he is, Lando.
Solid fixturing.
What do you think he's feeling ahead of this race, Karu?
Well, pole position is obviously a fantastic way to start this one. That being said, there's a lot of work to do between here and the checkered flag.
Well, this may well be a
soft medium
Grand Prix for the ages. So stick around and find out how it all ends.
We might have to do something else because of this. All right, soft dinner. Nice track graph. It's apparently the fastest strategy, too. Happy with that. Nothing else to do. Let's go.
We've got 44 laps ahead of us here in Spa as we get ready for the Belgian Grand Prix. There's a chance for Esteban Ocon to show what he can do here.
They start in P1, but will they be able to stay there? The first corner could be so crucial.
This should certainly be a good one, folks.
I'm trying to figure out something specific with, like, how to stop the AI from getting early surges on us.
And it's lights out, and away we go.
Mick's just sitting in fifth place now. This one's pretty effective so far. This strategy of not blowing everything up with Norris.
We want to manage our tire budget.
Confirm.
Thank you. Not really worried about signs. Guess it could surprise us, but... Got the best rear gunner we can get.
Key thing is to keep the tire in good shape. Keep your tire in good shape.
Copy.
Didn't expect that.
Get back to the rhythm. Yeah, confirm.
Okay, he's in like overdrive. I thought Norris would be able to defend, actually. We'll see. I think Sainz is going for a complete race destructivity. We can't go any faster.
Okay.
Can't go any faster for any longer. Look at those tires. Look what he's doing to them. I'm not panicking because he just suddenly found that pace. Now I think it's gone.
Though
I might need to put some pressure on with Norris now. Not sure where this pace came from for these signs.
Push now. Copy that.
I think we do need to do some responding from both ends.
Stay close.
try to stretch this out to 2 seconds, and then we will
overtake is available.
Yeah, confirm.
Let's have recharge on then, please.
Yeah, confirm.
Recharge off is okay.
Confirm.
Here's the replay. Now this is Logan Sargent. Oh, all right so far. And there goes the steering.
Uh-oh.
He took a gamble and it was just...
I realize that Sainz is going to have that fastest lap unless we can take it away.
Copy that.
Kind of running out of time to take it away. That's ridiculous. That shouldn't even... That should have been frowned upon by the FIA, actually. That's ridiculous. He basically swerved in the way. Ridiculous.
Just be careful with this tire.
Confirm.
Big lift.
Cool.
We have 4 minutes. We have to make this happen.
Can you use overtake?
Yep, confirm.
I can't believe they let him get away with that.
Now, so that's fine.
Now we need to immediately cool everything down and recharge.
That is the fastest
lap. Don't want signs with the fastest lap.
Let the tyres come back to you.
Yep.
So, recharge on.
Oh yeah, just destroying that tire.
No need to push the tires.
Confirm. Should have been okay.
Understood.
It's gonna be a little while. That's not exactly fully charged. I'm trying to space us out to being at least the amount of time of pit stop apart.
More lift and coast.
Yeah, cool.
Recharge off, please.
Okay, go. Weather is coming soon. Damp in 4 minutes. Probably about 3 seconds is where we can start normalizing. Sainz just lost pace. Tires are cold, now I have to actually warm them up.
Go up there.
see what pace you can do.
Copy that.
We want to manage our tyre budget. Science has pitted.
Okay.
We're box this lap.
Okay, box.
I think Science's race is ruined now. However, it's a very, very long time to our pit box. The rest of this race is just gonna be wet. It's gonna be a damp mess.
Okay. If you can, push.
Confirm.
Beautiful.
Thing is to keep the tire in good shape. Keep the tire in good shape.
I think these tires get to the end easily now.
Just be careful with this tyre.
I'm trying to keep Norris away, but it's harder than it seems, because a couple tenths of race pace is actually a lot in the grand scheme of things. I hate when it rains, because it just so massively oversimplifies race strategy. It's only getting 40 down. We're getting more up though. Although we seem to be dropping frames again.
We can use the pace now.
Copy.
You see how valuable a couple of tenths can actually be. I think I have to deliberately, like, get the tires cold to actually drop under 3 seconds again. Come on, Twitch, stabilize. Doesn't want to. Well, we have a yellow Mick is off.
It's currently yellow flags. Got it.
Here we are now, down at turn 17. There's the lockup. Just unable to control the car by that point.
Tire delta won't be huge.
Okay, keep looking after the tire.
Copy.
Are we done dropping frames? Looks like we might be. Six percent. Percent. stuck. 85. Neutral fuel.
More lit and coast.
Copy.
With Norris, I basically want to stay outside of a second to Volcan. We're maintaining about a 5% wear advantage over signs. Look at the gap to Gasly though, that's just ridiculous. Halfway in. And now science has dropped a second.
Little bit more like her, please.
Yeah, all good.
if we weren't at the top, would this be what it would look like for Red Bull? With their lead over the rest of the field? I'm just curious. I'll be right back.
Time to push on these tires.
Confirm.
Use deploy.
Copy that.
Thank you.
Okay. Doing like 148, so it's not, we're not even like too far off of what dry pace would be. Break the monotony with the lockup.
The car fails to respond. They were just unable to do much about it.
Yellow's ahead.
Copy.
There's a car in the wall.
Sergio Perez.
What the?
Oh, that's funny.
Just like that.
Not because of the safety car, though. Well, we'll watch him limp. I think there might be too much damage to his car. Ricardo approach. Oh no, Perez, you can't continue like that. He's got a pit. Is Ricardo really the worst driver in the worst car right now? Just weird. I assume Perez is going to be overtaken pretty quickly here. Yeah, it's like... Albon's actually worse. Not even with damage either. Come on, stay green. Green for like 5 seconds. I was like, haha. Thank you. Wow, that's a lot to lift. This is what a second of pace difference looks like, by the way.
No need to push the tires.
Okay.
Save as much fuel.
Confirm.
Full lift and coast.
Copy.
Yellow flags.
Okay.
Let's take lock up from Albon, another one of them. Starts
as they reach turn 17. Oh, and the car locks up. But that's just the risk you take, the later you leave it.
Stability. What if I go the other way?
Stay close.
And I just fry the tires.
Maximum pace now.
Copy.
Temperature is not changing. Not very quickly, anyway. I'm just speeding Ocon up to make sure he doesn't get overtaken in this experiment.
Thank you.
key thing is to keep the tyre in good shape. Keep the tyre in good shape.
Copy that.
That'll do it. Okay, let's not tempt fate. Yeah, look at that dip. Not looking good for the honey badger. Actually need to Yeah, that rain is gone. They're saying we're a minute away from complete dry. Yeah, is it 1 minute they're forecasting? Yeah.
Weather update. This rain has stopped.
Go fair.
this lap, box this lap.
Still running.
Yeah, it's gonna be dry tires.
Use the pace now.
Okay.
We could wait, but waiting is very punitive now. It's probably going to be at 1 by the time we're out. If not below. They sacrifice Verstappen for Sainz, or they sacrifice Sainz for Verstappen, rather. Bad idea.
Let's have maximum pace this lap.
Copy.
I can't decide what to do.
Okay, keep looking after the tire.
Copy.
Fastest lap is going to be like in flux. Yeah, there go the hitters. He probably still gets in front of Max anyway. Which is going to be the part of this I am not going to understand. HT19 is following. Thank you for the follow, sir. Spa, let's go. We're going.
Good lap.
Pai is doing so much better in the second half of the season.
Three laps including this one.
Copy.
Is that a fastest lap? No. Gained like a couple of seconds. That's so weird.
Careful with this tire.
Yeah, I want to let the tires cool so I can go all in at the end if need be. Buried it.
Which lap are we?
Two laps to go now.
Okay, mate, that is the fastest lap.
Yeah, got it.
Where are the Red Bulls at? Not quite in the same row. Perez fixed his wing. So Ricardo is not last anymore.
Maximum pace, maximum pace.
We're just going to make sure we take fastest lap.
That's a good lap. Good lap.
We're just lighting the timesheet on fire.
Yeah.
Yeah, tires are on fire. That might limit us. Just a little bit.
Yes!
Well done. Thank you very much. It's the checkered flag.
P2 and P1.
And it's Ocon! Ocon first over the line today!
What a race. Arouge is good. Man, there's a spread. I think I've ever seen this before. You've never seen the drivers actually get into the pits.
Now that's an excellent drive today from Esteban Ocon.
It was a truly excellent win, with everything working together for the team and driver.
A great display of team spirit there, as everyone finally gets the chance to share this moment. And there's no denying that the Frenchman deserves this result. He was absolutely brilliant.
And that's excellent, seeing both the team's drivers up there on the podium together.
French, Britain, and Spain.
Podium lineup at the Belgian Grand Prix. Now, Karun, with that result in mind, what would they be feeling like?
Yeah, that's pretty much what happens in real life.
I doubt they could be much happier.
Same podium ceremony.
What a great way to round out the weekend.
That is that for this weekend's F1 action here in Belgium.
For the next round, Formula One won't be straying too far. We'll be heading to the dunes of Zandvoort and the lightning speed of the Dutch Grand Prix.
Boom. -94 for Norris. Yeah, we've ripped right through your long-term objective, haven't we? More money. More money, more problems. Well, that's interesting. It gets to be a negative for everything now. Probably better off just researching now. Yes, pile on. Drag reduction, probably be my favorite thing to stick on the car. Manufacturer. Ah, underfloor research isn't even complete yet. Okay. Basically, we got like a tenth and a half of a mile of top speed mile per hour. We're doing a refurb. Car analysis. Red Bull's actually backwards in development now. Which is leading me to the belief we've tapped out our research. We've tapped out our current season development, rather. I'm gonna focus on drag reduction. Let's keep an eye on our cost cap as well. Manufacturer. Shut our camera off for a second. Are we still? All right. You'll cancel that out. Because we have new underfloors. do six of them. Can we get anything else out of this car? In actual fact, we can. I'm going to focus on drag reduction, though. That is so weird. Okay. That might be the last thing I designed on this end of the season. Fatigue reduction. Balance. This is just to do something with our scouts, really. Race simulator concerns. We'll approve the shutdown. Check the cost cap. Still looking okay. Underfloor is what we got to do a research project on. There's no signs of structural damage. Closing. All right, time to save and quit. Well, Red Bull was keeping up with us, but I don't know. They're way behind now. I don't know why. I'm guessing that they ran out of money and they can't even, like, replace the parts they designed now. Without going way in the hole on cost cap, so they might have just conceded. As far as, like, R&D goes. But I'm going to get out of here for the night. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already done so, feel free to hit the follow button one time, sub, like, and share on the YouTube end of things. And we'll catch you again next time. Till then, later on, guys.